Good morning class. Welcome to the online classes for science of class 8. Here we are going with a new chapter, that is chemical effects of electric current. So in this chapter we are going to see about some current and how this can be produced with the help of the chemicals, right? So we see different electrical appliances in our daily life, like tube lights, we see batteries, we see tester, we see screwdrivers. We see different LEDs. So around us we are seeing different electrical equipments. So we know that the electric current is passing through that substance. So whether these passing substances are the good conductor, right? They are the good conductor of electricity. That's why the current is passing through them. So what this good conductors means? So remember, any metals, when we are talking about conductors, that means the current can easily pass through them. So they will allow the current to pass through them. Second, that are insulators. So in this insulators the current cannot pass easily, like our wood, rubber, glass, this kind of materials, the current cannot pass through them. So the materials in which the current can easily pass through them, they are said to be the good conductors of electricity. That means the current can easily pass through them. So how this current is passing through them? We usually see what? That we just switch on our light, fan, or any other appliances, what we used to do, we just go and on our switch, we just replace it, right? We just displace that switch, and what will happen, that on displacing this switch, the current used to glow, right? The light used to glow or your fan used to run. What that means? That something is trying to make that electric current to flow. That means something or material should be there in that electric fields, right? That are allowing these electrons to flow or the charges to flow, due to which the electric current is being conducted. So why this light is glowing? So we just used to have the doubts, right? When we just have this doubts, what that is telling about the materials, we have already seen that the current, electric current passes through them, they are considered as the conductor of electricity. If you are talking about the elements which does not allow the current to pass through them, are considered as a poor conductor of electricity. So these are the different materials which we used to see in our daily life. So we can just differentiate between these materials. Now if we talk about equipments, now the first thing here you can see in the figure, this two figures, this is what a battery, we know this battery, or a cell. If we talk about this, then this is a bulb. What this is known as a tester, okay? This is a kind of tester. When it is put into a plug or to the hole of a switch, what will happen, that it will tell us that whether the current is flowing or not. Okay, so conducting electricities are happening only in the conductors, not in the insulators. So we can just test whether the electric current is flowing through them or not with the help of the tester. So this tester helps in us to tell what the current is flowing through them, or what is the value, or how much the current is passing through them. It will also tell us whether the current passed through the insulators or not. Okay, so now we will see that current is passing through every object like metal, liquid, gas. We used to know that whenever the liquid flow, many of us tell us that don't touch that liquid if it is in the condition of the current flowing, because current can easily flow through the water and we can get shock also. That means the current can easily flow into the liquids. But how this current is flowing through the liquid, or how can it pass through the solid? This will seen by us in this chapter itself, that is chemical effect of current. So if we add a battery, battery means the collection of the cells, okay? So if you are talking about cell, then a single cell, it is considered as, here you can see the single cell. If you are talking about battery, then different batteries will be seen, okay? Now just if it is working, that means the current is flowing. So see the activity number 14.1, that if we are just joining the free ends of the tester together for a moment, this completes the circuit of the tester and the bulb should glow, because we know that one of the end of the tester will be connected to the battery, other end of the battery will be connected to the bulb, and the bulb's next end will be connected to the other end of the tester. So tester is just the complete circuit, so the bulb will glow. However, the tester is not working, then the bulb cannot glow, okay? Now we are thinking that how these connections be are happening, that the current is flowing through that object, right? So this we will be seeing in the next activity, that Collect a few sample plastic or rubber. This is an activity for showing you that in insulators, the current should not or cannot flow. Okay, so the bulb will not glow if it is happens with that of the insulators. Now, if you are talking that when the liquid is there in between the two ends of the tester, that a current allows to pass, means that liquid is allowing the current to pass through them. So liquid is a kind of conductor. But the current flows in the circuit and the bulb glows, which means the liquid is allowing the current to pass. But the liquid does not allow. That means only the water is not allowing the current to pass. There is something else in the circuit. So we even see that the liquid sometimes conducts and sometimes the liquid does not conduct. This means that once the bulb will glow and another time the bulb will not glow. That means something is there in the liquid through which we can just make or increase their conduction, or their conductivity can be increased. Okay. So electric current passes through every object, but it depends on the effect of that object, whether the object is being shown or not. Like if you are talking about liquid, then sometimes it conducts and sometimes it does not conduct. If you are talking about solid, then the conductor should be there. Insulators does not allow the current to pass through them. And sometimes heating effect is also there to pass the current. Like if you are seeing your bulb, which we used to do it the first times, like yellow bulbs are there, no? The structure is made with a glass, and inside a glass some tungsten filament is there. That filament breaks and it gets black because it is fused. So by breaking that filament, we can see and tell that the bulb is already fused because it will not glow. So that bulb, what you can say, that tungsten get heat up, and due to that heating effect the current glows in the bulb. So the current flow and the bulb glows. Okay, so the current through a circuit is too weak, but the filament does not get heated. Okay, so that filament get heat up and allow the current to pass through them. So we can use another effect of electric current to make another kind of tester also. We can use different heating effects also. But now this LEDs, you may have seen these LEDs also. So these LEDs are also lightened up with a battery or a tester. How can we just use? So in place of electric bulb, we use a tester and LED glows even when the weak electric current flows through them, because LEDs does not need a high electric current to pass through them to get glow. They also glow in the small electric current even. So these LEDs are there. These LEDs have first terminal very shorter and other wire a longer one. So these are known as leads, and with these leads, if the positive and the negative terminal of the battery is connected, so the longer lead will be considered as the positive terminal and the shorter lead will be considered as the negative terminal. And to these positive and the negative terminals, if we add up the battery's positive and the negative terminal, they will start glow. So they will glow. Okay, so here see, when the three ends of the tester do not touch each other, there is an air gap between them, due to which a poor conduct of electricity, because air is a poor conduct of electricity, if there is a gap, the current cannot flow. But if you talk about the lightning, an electric current passes through air. But how this air is passing, because now only we said that air is a poor conductor, then how it is passing through the air? So there comes that they think about the classification of the materials into the conductors and the insulators. So actually, under certain conditions, most of the materials that we see can conduct the current. And if you are talking about some of the, they are the poor conductors of the current. So they behave as a conductor as well as the insulators. But if a liquid, if you are talking, then it will sometimes conduct and sometimes it will not conduct. Like if you are adding a salt into it, if you are adding a salt solution, preparing a salt solution, then the current will flow through it. That means the conductivity is increased by adding a salt to the liquid. So this is how we are just occurring about the different materials and how the current produces in that different materials due to its conductivity. So the materials which can allow the current to pass through it easily, then it will be considered as conductor. If you are talking about insulators, then the current will not flow through them, then that object or the materials will be considered as a insulators. Okay, so in the next class we will be seeing some more things about the chemical effect of the current, because in this chapter you are just seeing an introduction to the chapter, that how this chapter or what are the points that you are going to learn in this chapter. In the next class I will be explaining you each and every line of the